Hello, long time no see. Happy holidays. Let's see, which one do you worship? Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa. I know it's a lot out there, right? But we're not gonna talk about what you worship today. We're gonna talk about the name of Santa. How about that? I'm over here trying to give some truth, you know, trying to encourage people, especially the ones who say we believe and we read the Bible, and we have to get serious about our commitment and our relationship and loyalty to God, to Yahweh, to the one and only God, to Christ, absolutely. Anyway, right here, I'll give you time to get in. I know it's the holidays, you guys. Eating, family, it was all good today. I hope everyone had a blessed day today. And we basically, yes, the hat says naughty or nice. And I'm just trying to make a joke here, so bear with me. Because I'm not really funny, but I'm funny. I got mad jokes, but I'm not like a comedian. It just comes out when it comes out. But I know how to be humorous. Yeah, I know how to be humorous. Hi, hey, what up, cuz? How you doing, lovely? All right, so look at this word right here. We just gonna get right into it. I had this sign outside my house on the beginning of December. It says Santa stops here, and I told you I keep searching for some truth. I'm trying to record something for YouTube as well. You may get all of this Facebook. If not, you go over to hashtag religion wink. Because just like if you live in the hood, you've been hoodwinked about this, you've been hoodwinked. We've been religion winked, okay? And slowly but surely, God has given me some insight, some wisdom, and revelation on what really happened pre-slavery, for slavery and all this other stuff to kind of go down to our people, to our race. Anyway, the name of Santa. Oh, you gotta figure, black people didn't make up half these words. I mean, the Bible is said to be inspired by God, but you have a lot of these European scholars back then that was kind of crafty with words and kind of know how to shift things around, like letters, and one word can mean two things, like serpent. And repents is the same word. Look at the letters. The thing that caused us to sin is the thing that caused us to turn around and repent. I say repents with an S because the S is in the serpent. But it's the same word. Repents and serpent. Okay? The thing that caused us to sin is the same word that causes us to look back at God. Okay? There's a lot of words like that out here in the world. We just don't take time. It's called etymology, the study of words. These people were very crafty, cunning. The Bible says, very cunning, very conniving, very crafty, very swift, you know? And I love Psalms 83 because it says they conspired to make us forget who we were as a nation and really who we are, who we were as a people. But it's Christmas Day, and I want to break some things down about the word Santa. Because I'm going to put this down. You see, I have the word Santa here, right? You can see the word Santa stops here. Well, I had to take this out from in front of my house because I'm a believer. I'm not only a believer in just, God bless you, thank you. I'm gonna try to learn how to give thumbs up and stuff like that back. I really don't know how to work this side of the screen. Y'all guys be very patient with me. I learned how to hook my laptop up. I got my phone over here. So I'm trying to do the best I can to communicate and go back and forth with you. But it's about I just want to educate. I'm gonna tell you something about me. I could get caught up. I could get sidetracked. We could get lollygagging. I'm trying to just stay focused, and if I can educate, exhort, encourage, and comfort, that's it. I'm not here to tear down. I'm not here to get you to serve no other God but the gods you've been serving. You just gotta call them the right name and put things in perspective. Because for years, we've been religion week. We've been hashtag religion week. Go over to YouTube and see what I'm talking about. I can't say much here on Facebook, but the world needs to hear some of this stuff. Look at this word. Now, I'm going to tell you, prior to Santa Claus and all this other stuff that we've been made to worship and serve and just look at as, you know, idolatry, I guess, there was some people out to get God's people, and they was doing anything they can to make them, to make these people serve other gods other than Yahweh, other than the one true God in the same Bible that we all read. There's one God. There's other little gods, but there's a main God. There's, his name is Yahweh, okay? There was the Grecian Empire at one point, but then they dwindled out because Rome got bigger than them, and Rome took over everything. But we're not going to get in. Look at my Kwanzaa post for today, and you understand. I don't want, these are all different teachings, and I'll get talking for 7 hours. I just want to talk about the name of sin right now, because it really, like, God is really opening my eyes to religion. I'm woke to a lot. We could talk about the president and all the things, current events going on in the world, but for some reason, my heart and my purpose in life is fixated on religion, because I believe we've been bamboozled, hoodwinked, religion winked, and everything else when it comes to Christianity. And I know a lot of you Christians out, what the hell is she talking about? Well, if you open up your, I think you think Jesus was a comedian when he said, let those who have ears hear. He was looking dead at them. He seen everybody had two ears. Why would he say that? Because people could hear, but they don't understand. I'll say it again. Your natural man see and hear, but your spirit man perceive with your eyes and understand with your ears. That's why he said to them, let those who have ears, let them hear. He wasn't no comedian. He probably was being a jokester. Because he knows some people was deaf then. When Jesus came to open up deaf ears, you think everybody was born deaf and he performed all those miracles? No, he came to speak some words. And the Bible says that these words, they pierce asunder to the soul and the joint and the marrow and the spirit. They bring life, you know, these words that Christ was speaking. So we can get to speaking the words he spoke. Then we probably can get people into the kingdom of God, on the right path to changing their life and walking in righteousness, being just like all of us. None of us is perfect, but we don't want to leave them in the world. Because here's the thing I want to tell you real quick. If we all got to meet the maker one day, why not just go ahead and meet him now, start serving him, be down with him, have a good time with him, and you don't got to worry about what your last day is going to be like in the earth, because you already know you with God. And even then, Christ says himself, many going to say, Lord, Lord, we cast out demons and devils and this and that, and he's going to say, you know what, depart from me, you workers of iniquity, I don't even know you. Why? Because you steady calling him Jesus instead of Yeshua. You got to call him by his name. And that's all I'm trying to hear to help you. Call him by his name. Every other religion call their God by their name. Allah is Allah. He ain't just God. He can't be God. He got to take a different name than Yahweh. Ra. They can't be God. That's why Pharaoh fought so hard with Moses, because Ra was fighting against God. Pharaoh told Moses every time he did a performance, oh, I could do it better. Why? Because it's God's trying to fight against your God, Yahweh, God with a big G, not a little G. Anyway, these people always trying to go around and sabotage, oppress, hinder, downtrodden, poor spirited. You know what the Pope said yesterday on the news about baby Jesus? Oh, that's a whole nother one, because we're going to talk about baby Jesus, and we're going to talk about the King of Righteousness, and we're going to talk about the King of Shalom, and we're going to see in the Bible what God really say about who presented themselves in the flesh on behalf of your God. So you've been told several different stories.